Hello and welcome to the episode 13 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today's show will feature a goodbye to inferior venues, a debut on a very important TV show, and the first mention of the Beatles splitting up. On the 13th of January 1961, the Beatles, with Pete Best on drums, performed for their second of 13 nights at the Aintree Institute in Liverpool. In 1962, the band, still featuring Pete Best on drums, played the Hambleton Hall in Liverpool. It was their 16th and last time in this venue. With Brian Epstein becoming their manager, this type of inferior, shabby halls were becoming off-limits for the band. On this date, in 1963, the Beatles were at the Alpha Television Studios in Birmingham for a TV appearance secured by their music publisher, Dick James. It was their most important TV appearance to date in Thank You, Lucky Stars, a show that was broadcast through regional ITV networks, reaching throughout the nation at various times. It was the pop music program as far as British teenagers were concerned. Even if featured at the bottom of a seven-act bill, it was a real coup for the lads. For most viewers, the Beatles miming Please Please Me at the end of the first half of the program was their first encounter with a band. The show was aired first in the Midlands and the north of England on the 19th of January between 5:50 and 6:30 p.m. London and other areas followed. On the 13th of January 1964, good news came from the United States. After selling 1 million copies in the previous week, the sales of I Want to Hold Your Hand reached a singular plateau. It was estimated that the single sold 10,000 copies per hour in New York City alone. To capitalize on the success, labels VJ and Swan decided to reissue previous Beatles singles, to which they had full right, having Capitol Records failed to show any interest in the material. This would eventually make the early 1964 US charts inundated with Beatles releases. In 1965, the Beatles were featured in the two houses of the 17th, another Beatles Christmas show night at the Odeon Cinema in Hammersmith, London. On the 13th of January 1966, George Harrison, Mick Jagger, and Jagger's girlfriend Chrissy Shrimpton went together at the Dolly's nightclub in London. While this event doesn't amount to much in the big scheme of things, it is a good chance to point out that the alleged arch rivalry between the Beatles and the Rolling Stones was a press fabrication. Not only the members of the two bands were good friends, but they also often consulted each other to plan their record and single releases, in order not to compete with each other. This is not to say that there was no desire to outperform each other, but there were no ill feelings, no envy, and no dirty tricks. Although both bands regularly fueled the media narrative when they felt like it. The 13th of January 1968 was the final day of the George Harrison recordings for the soundtrack of the film Wonderwall at the EMI's facilities in Bombay, India. The sessions took place as usual between 10 a.m. and 7 p.m. local time. All in all, as we have seen, George limited his role to that of producer, using local performers and not playing a single note of the music. Despite this, the album was released under his name. Finally, in 1969, the eighth day of rehearsals for the Get Back TV special, in front of a camera crew, went down at the Twickenham Film Studios. George Harrison did not show up, naturally, having left the band on the 10th of January. John Lennon was late in arriving too, and most of the session was occupied by discussions about the Beatles and their future. John wondered aloud about whether or not he wanted George back in the band, agreeing when Paul said that Harrison had drifted away from the others in the recent months. McCartney conceded that the fact that he and Lennon acted like the leaders of the band was a reflection of the school day's pecking order, when George was too young to have his own voice and his way about things. Later in the day, Lennon stated that their work had become formulaic, and that the only challenge left for them to stir things up was to go solo. But he seemed indeed unsure about leaving the comfort zone that the band offered. This was the first time that he mentioned the idea of splitting up the Beatles as a serious proposition. This concludes another episode of What a Fab Day. If you like the podcast so far, please consider checking www.simonmas.com/support to find ways to support it. On my website, you can also find all of my other music projects and a form to contact me if you want. In the description instead, you will find a link to the complete list of all the songs recorded during the Get Back project and an Amazon affiliate link with all the books and material you might want to delve into the history of the Beatles by yourself. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.